Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Tech Things. It's been a while. I'm sure you've all missed me and I can't blame you. I am pretty amazing. Today we're gonna be looking at another video and we're gonna be reacting to it. This is one coming out of CES and it's about a product that I'm personally super excited about. The ROG X13 Flow or Flow X13. Anyway, it's a new laptop coming from Asus that I believe if it checks, like if it does everything that it promises that it can do, it will be the laptop to watch for this year. And it should definitely win laptop of the year. So I don't wanna waste any of your time. I think it's the coolest thing announced at CES so far. So I just wanna get right into it. I wanna show you it and hopefully you will agree with me. So without any further ado, nothing is softer than water, yet nothing can resist it. It has, like, okay, they're trying to do kung fu, I guess. Clear your mind. Flex your power. Be ready for anything. Lots of kung fu references. Transform your experience with the all-new ROG Flow X13. Fast, fluid, and freeform. So I guess it's kind of what they're kind of going for, like the fact that with this laptop, you're supposed to be able to transition from any like workflow that you're doing. Like if you need a two-in-one, it's that. If you need a good laptop, it's that. If you need a powerful workstation, actually, I'll let them explain. You can stay in the creative flow anywhere.
The ROG Flow is a 13-inch, ultra-slim gaming laptop with a convertible design.
Yeah, basically you don't hear that every day, a 13-inch convertible gaming laptop. I think it's the first one that actually checks all of those boxes, and it's not even done yet. Convertible design.
And powerful components. Versatility was our big goal here. We wanted to create a device that could do more. Game. Create. Entertain. We're trying to combine the best of every world. Desktop class performance, effortless portability, and everything in between. The gravity wave pattern we designed.
Okay, I'm just gonna go back real quick to what he's kind of talking about at that part of the video where he's addressing the fact that they're trying to be everything. So like, we're all kind of looking that for that all-in-one computer device, right? Something that can be like an iPad that's touch, that we can watch and we can use to consume media. Something that's portable yet work friendly so that you don't have to attach a keyboard to like an iPad that just has a keyboard there that you can just type and that you can just work on. But sometimes that product has to be thin and light enough. But sometimes thin and light often means not powerful. So the other end of the spectrum is you need something that's powerful as well. So it's trying to give you desktop class performance as well. So kind of checking those three boxes. So it's kind of like a tablet, it's a laptop, and it's a desktop all in one. And it's trying to do all three of those things at a high level. Very interesting.
Is our way of representing the power inside the Flow X13. It's this one-of-a-kind 3D texture that functions as grip, but also speaks directly.
I wonder how this is going to work with, like skins, like D-brand skins. I wonder if that will work. Back to this Kung Fu guy.
Flowing smoothly between work and play in different settings requires speed and agility. We had to overcome several challenges to make the Flow X13 the world's most powerful 13-inch.
Okay, so it's coming. This is also important. So if you don't know, like CPU speak, it's coming with an AMD Ryzen 9 5980HS. So this is the mobile variant of their CPU. So AMD makes desktop CPUs that go inside big tower computers. Well, this is what they put inside laptops. And this is new for this year. It's, I believe it's based off of AMD's newest architecture or the newest technology for this year. And they're pairing it with an NVIDIA GeForce GTX GPU. This is all going to be internally inside of the Flow 13 itself, inside of a 13-inch package. Device.
Our first step was to address the heat from the CPU. We painted it with a layer of liquid metal to lower the temperature and improve thermal transfer. Then we rethought the thermal module. We altered the heat pipes to increase contact area, reshaped our arc flow fans to reduce noise, and rearranged everything to fit 3 heat sinks and fan outlets. These changes allow the compact design to include a GPU that's fast enough to play any game.
And I think this is funny because they're talking about still the internals, about how they made the internal GPU, like, you know, heat resistance, and they're doing all these things to keep it cool so you can play any games, but they don't really intend for you to play games on their internal GPU.
Add the convertible form factor, and the Flow X13 is the most versatile, ultra-portable gaming device.
Compact without compromise.
We wanted something that sounded impressive.
This is what I wanted to get to.
The device is flexible as a typical eGPU, but easy carry and faster as well. So we created the XG Mobile, the world's first ultra-portable eGPU. It's tiny compared to typical external graphics docks, but still has a top-of-the-line GeForce RTX 3080.
Did you just catch that? A 3080 is going to be in there. That's NVIDIA's newest offering from this year that you can't get anywhere. But inside the tiny package, you're going to get a GTX 3080 that you can connect to the Flow X13. And that's not the best part, because eGPUs have existed before. This kind of sounds a lot like what Razer intended for the Razer 13 a few years ago. You know, they announced at CES, hey, Razer 13 inch laptop. I don't think it, you know, it definitely was not a convertible, nor was it touchscreen, I believe. But it came up with eGPU, and the promise was that, hey, you can have this ultra portable, light and portable gaming laptop that you can connect to eGPU and make it more powerful. That's not exactly what we got. There are so many problems with eGPUs, mostly because of that connection. That Thunderbolt 3 connection is a bottleneck. It's not fast enough to transfer all that video data and other things back and forth. So it's not really worth it as it is currently to get a GPU, the eGPU. But let's continue.
The eGPU gets a faster PCI Express.
So look at that new dock, that PCI Express connection. This is what changes things.
Connection that goes directly to the CPU without hopping through other chips that introduce bottlenecks.
So do you see what it says right here at the bottom? This is 58% faster than a Thunderbolt connection. So what this essentially means is that you should have no bottleneck. Like, if you use this, if you plug, it's a little big, it's a little clunky, and I believe it is proprietary, which is another problem, because it's like, okay, if only Asus is making this and no other manufacturers are using this, that means Asus can charge whatever they want for these things, and you're just beholden onto them to have to get it from them. But besides that, the fact that you no longer have a bottleneck means that you can essentially live the dream. Have an ultra-portable laptop that you can use for other things, and it's a convertible. You can do convertible things with it if you want to get a pen and write on it, for things like that. If you want to use it as a regular laptop and type, you got it. If you want to game lightly on it itself, you can do that. But if you need more power, you can connect it to this eGPU that also is a dock, because it has more ports on the back, and it's 58 times faster than a regular Thunderbolt.
Separate USB link dedicated
with a USB-C link, I thought of it. Yeah.
IO and power. Putting all that together in a single cable was really challenging, but we pulled together and made it happen. The XG Mobile is a mobile docking station that can connect to a wide array of devices.
Look at all of those ports. You get 4 regular USB-A types. You get a HDMI, a display port, SD card. I don't see it there. I believe it's the full size SD card, not micro SD. And you get gigabit Ethernet, all included when you get this add-on. Yeah.
It even has an integrated adapter that powers everything, including the laptop, so you don't have to carry a separate power brick.
No power brick.
Adapt, do anything.
This guy's so weird.
The Flow X13's fluid convertible design frees you from the constraints of the traditional laptop form factor. Two display options let you take.
Okay, this for me is a little weird. This one scene right here, because this gamer, like, he's gaming on his laptop when he has a big screen right there, and he's plugged into the eGPU. So if I were him, like I would send the game to the bigger screen and game on that. But besides that, this is like, you know, this is the intended usage. You have the dock right there. You hook it up to your screen and you just plug your laptop to it when you want to use it like this. But when you're on the go, you just unplug one connector. Just bloop and you're good to go. And you just have a regular laptop. And as you saw, let me go back a little bit. Yeah, this right here is the regular USB-C charger. It's not that big, so this is all you basically have to carry with it as you go about your business.
The Flow X additional laptop form options let you tailor the experience. You can get a 120Hz panel for gaming, or go for
120Hz full HD panel, 120Hz, and a 13-inch convertible gaming laptop. Like, did you think you would say these words like together in one sentence? But here you are. Or you can get a 4K panel for creators as opposed to gamers.
4K for creating.
I'm just not sure how both 120 or 4K will affect the battery life. That's what I'm most concerned about. I think the 4K would be more battery consuming, but 120 does consume more battery than just like a lower, like a frequency refresh rate. So that'd be interesting to see, like, which one gives you better battery. Like, some people, like, they game casually, or they're a creator, or basically they want this, but they just want it for, like, whatever given the most battery life when it's just a regular convertible laptop. So it's important to know which one of these two display options will help or hinder your battery life.
Both use a taller 16x10 touchscreen.
And it's 16x10. Oh my goodness.
Our edge-to-edge design fits a comfortable full-size keyboard into the 13-inch body. The power button has an integrated fingerprint reader.
And it has a fingerprint.
Flow fast even on the go. You can move freely with an enormous battery that easily gets through the day. Power adapter is half the size.
This is what I was saying about the power adapter.
You can charge any Type-C device, and you can even stay unplugged.
So if you have other USB-C devices, you can take one charger for your laptop, for your phone. If your headphones use USB-C, if you have an iPad Pro or another tablet, you can, with just this one charger, which is kind of like the intended dream that we had when we introduced USB-C, is that one plug to rule them all. And it's like we're getting there, you know.
Plug by charging from portable USB power packs.
This is a device for those who dare to want more. Power, precision, and portability. Wherever inspiration takes you, go with it. ROG Flow X13. Combat is the new impact.
Okay. So that's basically the whole video, right? So you saw all these things, and hopefully you're excited as me, and you probably want this thing too. So here are some other questions that you probably have that I would like to maybe answer for you if I could. Let's see. So for one, the laptop itself, from what I'm told, with the laptop and the dock together combined, from what I could see from pre-orders, is about $3,000. Now that's a hefty price. Hopefully it comes down. Obviously it's not gonna come down anytime soon. I believe pre-orders are live right now. But basically that's the dream. That's like what we all wanted, you know. Like, it seems as though with this package there are no compromises. Anything and everything that you want to do, you'll be able to do with this package. But of course we'll have to wait and see, because promises were made a few years ago with the Razer Stealth Blade 13, and those promises were not met. They were not met. But like, this is AMD we're talking about. Last year they released the Zephyrus G14, and that laptop was insane. It was laptop of the year just about everywhere that you can look or you can imagine or even think of. So like, with this, like, building off of that with an even better better CPU in there, a 5980 as opposed to the 4800, I believe, that was in the Zephyrus G14 last year, this should give you better performance. They're claiming better thermals. And it's like, we're not basing this off of nothing because the G14 actually exists and we know how good of a laptop that was. This should, you know, by all metrics, be even better. And if that eGPU really has no bottlenecks for creators, for gamers, or who want one laptop, you don't want to have a gaming desktop at home and then a laptop that you have to maybe transfer things from, or you have to remember, okay, where's my laptop and where's my desktop? But like, you just kind of have everything in one. Wherever you go, you have all of your files, you have all of your documents because you have one laptop. And when you need more power, you just plug it in. And I haven't even gotten to the best part. Because those of you who got the G14 last year, this will make you so sad. I think it's gonna make you sad. The best part is that we're living in a world nowadays where you need a webcam because Zoom and Skype and who uses Skype? Microsoft Teams or WebEx or whatever programs you use nowadays to communicate with the outside world. You need a webcam for them to be able to see you and for you to be able to see them. Well, you could see them without the webcam, but that's besides the point. But essentially what I'm trying to say is that last year, the main gripe that I had with the G14 is that they didn't know when they designed it and they released it. They didn't think gamers really needed webcams. Webcams were 720p, and it's like, oh, who uses them and who wants them anyway? But in the world we're living in now, webcams are essential, and the G14 did not have a webcam. But with this Flow 13, there will be a 720p webcam as well. I never thought that I would be so happy about a 720p camera, but just the fact that if and when you need it, because you'll be somewhere at a time where you have to be at a meeting, whether you're on campus or you're at the office, where you don't have, you know, a more elaborate webcam available, and you just want to use the webcam you have, well, with this, there is a built-in webcam. Anyway, I'm really excited for this. I can't wait to see this thing in action. It is a little pricey right now, but again, this is the first iteration of this technology. I hope this grows. I hope this spreads. My only pause, the only reason I'm like slightly is that the proprietary connector. It's a great connector, but the fact that it's proprietary gives me pause. Cause to pause. I'm gonna get that right one day. But anyway, besides that, I think it's gonna be cool. This is the only laptop that AMD is releasing this year that has this connector so far, but I would love to see more and more laptops that AMD releases using the same connector. And what I fear is that, like, maybe a year or two from now, AMD develops like a new connector that's even faster, even better, and that looks different, and they no longer support this one. So if you get a new eGPU, because obviously with that enclosure, you can't just open it up and put your own GPU in there. You kind of have to buy that proprietary as well. So it's like you have to keep on buying a whole new dock every time. And if they change that connector on you and you still have this X-Flow 13 or Flow X13, I'm gonna get that name right one time eventually too, but if you still have this one from this year, then it's gonna be like, oh man, like everyone has a newer connector and I can't even upgrade. Like I'm fine with the laptop performance itself, but I just want to upgrade my dock performance. You wouldn't be able to do that. But anyway, besides that, I think it's really cool. If the price wasn't so darn high, I'd get one right now. Hopefully Asus will send me a review unit. I'm waiting for it in the mail. But anyway, let me know your thoughts. Are you as excited for this thing as I am? Or do you want to get one? But yeah, just let me know down below and we can discuss together. And if you haven't done so yet, make sure to like and subscribe to this video and do all the various things that you're supposed to do every time that you watch one of my videos. You don't have to do it on any other video channel on YouTube, but on my channel, you must subscribe and like and do all these things. But anyway, thank you for sticking this long with me and watching. And just let me know your thoughts down below. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.